Comedy taking him for the new day. That's brand new, of course, and continuous right there from Troy Sneed. I want to thank him for a new day. Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to one of the most exciting gospel shows that speaks to your life. It's the Songbook of Gospel. You clicked it, you got it, and hopefully it's what you expected, a great song and a word of inspiration in this season that's going to bless you. Of course, I'm Simone Malone, your radio feel-good man, one of your most trusted and respected voices in radio. And for those of you that can see the video on Facebook and my YouTube channel, thank you. Thank you so much for watching and tuning in. What I ask you guys to do, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Trusted Voice in Radio. It's one word. And you can download the link that we have right there to your phone and to your cell phone so you can listen in and carry us wherever you go. We heard all over the country from coast to coast. I get emails and telephone calls and messages from people as far as India that tune into this radio station to be blessed of the Lord. Well, I'm going to get right into the word of the Lord. We got about two more weeks left in the month of August, and summer be ending, and we want to welcome all of our students back to school, all of our freshmen that are going back to college or starting college, and those that are returning back to college. We pray blessings over you, excellence in your academics. I've been there some years ago, so I know. Give your best. Give what you need to feel whole and good each day, and strive to be the best that you can be. Each one teach one. Well, I want to get into the word of the Lord, and I thank you once again for those of you that like and subscribe to my YouTube channel and like these inspirational moments, because this word is true and it speaks to my life. When the Lord gives me a word, when I'm going through my studies and he gives me a subject matter to share, it helps Brother Simone Malone, because I realize that God has his hands on my life and he has anointed me to share a word of inspiration. I tell many people I carry my mother's mantle, the late evangelist Jesse Malone, who passed down that evangelical ministry to me to share words of exhortations and motivation to you. Well, I want to talk about a new purpose, because a lot of us are going through some changes and shifts. There's so many changes that's happening in America. And we're going to pray that God will keep us on focus and keep us in our lane and keep us on the right path, because some of us get distracted from the enemy. Some of us get turned off from things. But I want you to know there is a new purpose for me and for you, too. You can say amen right there. I want you to go into the book of Acts number 9, 1 through 9 to read during your devotion. That's Acts number 9, 1 through 9. But I want to focus on in the book of Jeremiah 29:11 says, I know the thoughts and I think toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. Not of evil. To give you a future. Thank you, Father. And a hope. Let me read that again for those of you that are Bible believers. You can go right there. It's a New King James Version or different versions. But Jeremiah 29:11 says, I know the thoughts that I have toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. We're wondering what's going on in America. We need more peace and not evil, to give you a future and a hope. So what are you worried about? Some of you may be discouraged because you're concerned about your future. You're concerned about where you're going and where God is going to take you. But you need to be encouraged, because he said that, and a hope. If structure can find new life and purpose, why not you? Think about these men in the Bible whose lives took an unexpected direction. Hear me out. There was Jacob, who wrestled with the angel of the Lord. That's Genesis 32. You can go there and read it. And Moses, who talked to a burning bush. That's Exodus 3. Paul, who was temporarily blinded. Acts 9. Their stories, hear me out, were different, but all had a change of purpose, who their encounter with God sent them down a new path. Some of you know that you're going through some things and God is shifting you, and he's speaking to you, and he's directing you for a new path. Some of you are tired of the same things that you have been doing, and God is speaking to you for a new purpose, and you need to walk into it. Don't worry about what people say. Don't worry about what people do, because when God gives you something, he's going to open the door. He's going to give you the tools. That's right, financially and educationally, that you need for your new purpose. You too may experience circumstances that change the course of your life. life. And some of you know, as I speak to you live from Studio 236, you're going through some changes. I know that God is changing me. He's molding me and making me a better brother, Simone Malone. He's cutting some meat and he's trimming some things. He's pushing some people out of my life for the purpose and the journey. Can I get a witness right there? A simple shift can help you recognize your course of action for what you are called to do. Many of you know you're called for different things. You know your gift and your calling. God has gifted you from the time and given you a talent from the time that you were born. You just need to develop it and grow into the person that you truly admire and use it to your ability because you are called to do. But God reminds us of this. I love you before you love me. I want to give you hope and a future. God wants you to have bountiful blessings. God wants to bless your life. God wants to just open up the rivers and pour you out a blessing, but you got to stay focused on your purpose. There is a new purpose for your life. Somebody knows that you're ready to go through a different thing. You're ready to try something new, and you've been contemplating whether you should do it. Well, I'm here to encourage you as the man of God that God has placed me on this platform to encourage you, to let you know that you need to move forward. That's right, not go backwards. Move forward into your gift and your calling and your purpose. Give all of your worries to God because he cares about you. John 4:19, Jeremiah 29:11, 1 Peter 5:7, and John 10:10. Got to go there and read it. As you cling to God's promises, ask him to reveal the new direction and purpose for your life. Some of you know that you've been praying and the enemy's been speaking to you and telling you, no, you don't need to open up that business. You don't need to get into that relationship. You don't need to get into that new job. But I want you to know there is a new purpose for you. That opening up that new ministry. That's right. Starting that new choir. That's right. That is a new purpose for you. God has a purpose for your life. So what do you have to do is follow him. Let him speak to you and believing that he's going to direct you where you need to go. You have the ability to take circumstances that have been handed to you and make them into something great. Choosing to love your life no matter what crosses you path. You can create an atmosphere of jubilance that you have a purpose and called for greatness. I want you to remember today that you need to keep your eyes on the Lord and you won't lose sight of life purpose. I want to encourage you and I want to just charge you today that you have purpose and you have a new purpose. You have new eyes and God is opening up your eyes. Thank you, Father, to be able to see new opportunities and development for you. That's right. I believe that God is opening up some major doors for me and for you too. You have to believe that there is a purpose for your life. Just in case you may be discouraged and the enemy begin to speak to you and tell you you don't have no purpose, I want you to know as you watch this moment wherever you are across the country, locally and nationally, that you have purpose for your life. You need to have a purpose-driven life. You need to surround yourself with people that are driven for purpose and people that are called to do greatness. You need to get away from negativity because that's not going to help you, thank you, Father, in your purpose. But God wants you to saturate yourself in his word so he can speak to you and guide you. Just in case you exit off the wrong highway and you think you're going down a highway that's not leading you to your purpose, I want you to make a U-turn. I spoke about that. You need to make a U-turn and get back on the right path, because when you're on your right path, you feel something in your soul. You know you feel safe. You're in his safe zone when you're on a line of purpose. And I want you to lift your head up today and I want you to be encouraged. There is a new purpose for your life. Some of you know you got some ideas you've been writing down. You've been writing down ideas. You've been sharing them with people. You got to be careful what you share to people about your purpose, because they may be jealous of you and may take the idea. But I want you to know when God gives you something for your life, he seals it in the Holy Spirit for you. And I want you to know you have purpose for your life. And I want you to lift your spirit up today and know that God is going to open major doors for you. You just have to keep on striving. Keep on working on you. That's right. You got to keep on working on you to perfect the gift that's in you. How do you expect to get opportunities if you don't work at it? You got to work at everything and attack all of your obstacles with prayer and enthusiasm. There you have it. There you have it. The inspirational moment. A new purpose. You got to read Jeremiah 29:11. It says, I know the thoughts that I have toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you a future and a hope. So I want you to know that no matter what is going on around you, the angels will protect you because there is a great future. People say, I don't know, Simone. I just don't know. I want you to know you got to take all of those negative thoughts and conversations. Make sure your conversations are facial expressions of advertisements of your faith and hold on and believe that there is a new purpose. Let's touch and agree. Father God, I thank you for giving me this word to share to my viewers and listeners out there that are watching me, God. Lord, I ask you to speak to somebody's heart today, God. Speak to that pastor, God. Speak to that lay member. Speak to that deacon, God. Speak to that choir member, God. Speak to that nurse, God. Speak to that doctor, God. Speak to that gospel singer, God. Lord, we need new purpose in our lives so we can move into the right source and direction. Because, God, when you give us a new purpose, you bless us right there. You bless us right there so we can strive into being the best, God, that we can be an instrument of faith to others, God, and bless them, God, where they are, God. Lord, I ask you to go through Facebook and YouTube and Instagram and Periscope, God, where people are watching and hearing my voice. I ask you, God, to give them a new purpose, God, and charge them with the Holy Ghost, God. Endow something special down into their spirit, God, in the name of Jesus Christ, God. Somebody wants to give up today, but we're going throwing out the lifeline of hope and encouragement because we believe, God, that good things are going to happen for us. We believe what your word has said, God, and we know we're going to have some ups and downs. We're going to have some surprising twists and turns, but God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I ask you to give that person new purpose, God, so that they can reach their goals and aspirations, God, because we know, God, we have work to do. We got work to do down here, God. We got souls to reach, testimonies to share. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray if you believe God with me, you ought to say amen. My God, I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Some of you know there is a new purpose for you, and I want you to hold on. I don't want you to give up because I'm not giving up. No way. No matter what comes in my way, I have shared before that everything that the devil has tried to do to me, God has allowed him to get out of my way through my cancer and through my surgery. God has been there. And some of you know that God birthed things out of you when you're sick and you've been pushed back against the wall. And I want you to know today, my brother and sister, there is a new purpose. Thank you, Father, for your life. There you have it live out of Studio 236. A new purpose. Read Acts 9, 1 through 9 during your devotion, but focus on Jeremiah 29:11 that says, I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil. Think good. Think on these good things to give you a future and a hope. That is something to rejoice about. You ought to dance right there on that. A new purpose for your life.